And the retaliation for 9/11 snowballed into two decades of conflict, chaos and political fracture. America's global war on terror cost countless lives and trillions of dollars. Yet Western intelligence chiefs say the threat of terrorism is greater now than it was in 2001. Our US correspondent Anna Burns-Francis is in New York.
On the day the Twin Towers fell, America was forever changed.
News story to tell you about. Apparently, a plane has just crashed into the World Trade Center here in New York City.
So too were those there to witness it.
Firefighter ran up to me and just said, "Just run, just run." And I dropped the payphone, sort of left it swinging there, and was running. And this cloud of dust was sort of enveloping me, and thinking, you know, I'm about to get hit in the head by, you know, a steel beam or something. What's about to happen?
Kiwi journalist Lauren Quaintance stayed for hours at Ground Zero, reporting on the attack as dust and chaos swirled all around.
Called my mother in Wellington and woke her up in the middle of the night, and I couldn't really explain what was going on. I just said, something terrible has happened. I can't explain it right now. All you need to know is I'm all right.
She was, but thousands of people had died, and the United States was determined to seek justice and revenge.
Freedom itself was attacked this morning by a faceless coward, and freedom will be defended.
The September 11 attacks became the launch pad for America's war on Afghanistan and the hunt for Osama bin Laden. But it became the forever war, 20 years of military action that's only just come to an end.
An end that came at enormous cost. Osama bin Laden was captured a decade into the conflict, but more than 200,000 lives were lost, most of them civilian. And when America pulled out last month, the Taliban swiftly reclaimed power.
We are not shining the way we used to shine. I do think that it has been a defeat for the pride of America and the respect that we have had around the world.
British and US intelligence suggests the threat of terrorism is greater now than it was in 2001.
There's no doubt that recent events in Afghanistan will have heartened and emboldened some of those extremists.
And then there's Guantanamo Bay. 39 prisoners have been held captive there for years without trial, including the so-called mastermind of the attacks. For the families of those who died on September 11, none of it, the war, the retribution, the two decades of time, has watered down the grief of that day. This year, watching from afar, Lauren Quaintance admires a city she knew would always come back.
New York is resilient, and I think that in a way the city is bigger than these disasters.
Tomorrow, the city will once again pause on that moment. Together, the nation will grieve. America's war on terror brought loss on an unimaginable scale, and now it's weaker for it. Anna Burns-Francis, One News, New York.